Hi, I'm Rhea Chervin, AI architect and evangelist at Intel Corporation. And today I'm incredibly excited to introduce our new multimodal AI visual generator edge reference kit using the OpenVINO toolkit. This is an exciting kit that can generate 3D animated outputs given a variety of different inputs, including text commands, voice commands, and images. We'll be exploring today how to navigate this edge AI reference kit using the Intel AI PC, which is the recommended hardware for this application. Of course, you can also use non-AI PC-related hardware, and we'll explore how to do that as well. In this walkthrough, we'll be going over the various open source elements, including where you can find the code and how you can reproduce it today. This kit consists of a number of different multimodal AI and Gen AI models. On one hand, we have Nano Llama, which is being used for multimodal inputs, and Whisper, which is being used for speech-to-text transcription. We also have additional models like Super Resolution and Depth Anything for being able to refine the outputs of our image generation model with latent consistency models. So we'll explore how these models are used as part of the reference kit and how they can be applied in different ways in order to get some exciting results. We'll be using Gradio as the front-end interface for the application and the kit. This kit focuses on the idea of video game development, and specifically looking at character and scenery generation. The kit allows game developers to create high-fidelity graphics and scenery rapidly and on the fly using different types of commands, including voice and text commands and image inputs, with a lot of flexibility to modify how the different AI models are being used to create 3D animated outputs that you can interact with over time. This app lives in our GitHub repository, where you can find a lot of the different content corresponding to the kit as it's evolving over time. As part of the GitHub repository, you'll see a number of files, including various Python files, as well as requirements files, in order to help with the installation and reproducing process for your setup. Here, if you navigate over to the README, you'll also find additional information on how to download the models and go ahead and get your setup up and running in order to be able to leverage the models directly. The GitHub repository also contains additional Python files, including the main UI file, requirements.txt files in order to get started with the installation process, and additional pipelines and utility files in order to load our models into place. There are a few setup requirements in order to be able to download, install, and run this demo on your system. First, you need to ensure that you've got enough RAM and disk space in order to be able to load and download all of these models. Specifically, we optimize them with the OpenVINO toolkit to improve memory efficiency and reduce the model footprint and model size. It's important to make sure that the conversion process and additional elements have the right dependencies in order for that to take place as well. So we would recommend having Python 3.11.9 or Python 3.12 versions, and also ensuring that you have access to your Llama 2 or Llama 3 models or any LLMs that you would like to use for this demo. In this case, we have Llama 3 8 billion instruct in place for our LLM model, but you're welcome to plug it in with something else if that interests you as well. Some of the key files for this project outside of the requirements.txt file include the download and prepare models Python file, which has additional information that we've created in order to help make it easier to prepare and download different models. Here we can download the models that we would like to choose, in this case, downloading Whisper, Llama 3, 8 billion instruct, and preparing them by converting them and optimizing them using the OpenVINO toolkit for real-time execution, as well as a number of other models, including Super Resolution and Depth Anything and V2 and more. Additionally, we also have our radiouI.py file, which is the main file that contains all of the different models being prepared and run at inference. And this can be customized depending on any background settings that you'd like to identify, models that you'd like to add or remove, advanced parameters that you'd like to play with and add or remove from the user interface, and much more. Now that you understand how the kit is configured, let's go ahead and take a look at a brief demo of the solution and explore further what the configuration options look like. Here's a sample demo of the application running in practice. What I'm going to go ahead and do is use my image as an example for the multimodal input and stage one of this demo. So I'm going to go ahead and take a quick picture of myself here. And after I've done that, it triggers the first stage of the pipeline, which is our nano lava model that is taking as input the input image and providing a simple caption for us to be able to use in order to incorporate that as the theme of our prompt for the senior generation. Next, I can go ahead and start to record in a prompt using Whisper to turn that from speech to text. Let's go ahead and input something like, a dark mage with a hidden secret and a library full of mystical books. I went ahead and stopped it here, and the model is now transcribing my speech to text real time. Now that we've got the transcription in place, we can go ahead and click on this button, Add Theme to Prompt, in order to append our theme to our prompt. We can, of course, modify it textually if we'd like. For example, maybe we want to only include a woman with glasses and a white shirt and remove the dots part and keep the rest of the prompt completely intact. We can also choose to refine the prompt with a large language model. Again, this can lead to different types of outputs from our large language model depending on how we would like it to process the information. Sometimes we do see hallucinations, but in most cases, the large language model is able to adequately summarize the prompt and bring out some key details, and sometimes even creatively add some additional details as well. Our LLM model has produced the final prompt of a portrait of a woman with a book and a candle in a dimly lit room with a hint of mystery and a touch of magic. We can modify that as well if we'd like, but let's go ahead and click Generate Image to see our latent consistency models generated in action. Now that Llama 3 has provided us with a nice prompt for us to use, we can now see that the image generation is taking place pretty quickly, and we're going to see it pop up on the screen shortly. Perfect. Now that our image has been generated, a depth map is now going to be generated using the Depth Anything V2 model in order to create a depth estimation from this so we can create our final 3D animated output. As our depth map is being generated, what I've done on the side here is have a HTTP server with node.js running so that we're able to see the final output in a small HTTP server that we're running in the browser. Now, if I go ahead and refresh this, we can see our final generated output and go ahead and interact with it as well. So as you can tell, there's a lot of opportunities for being able to leverage this demo in different setups. We can envision the pane to the left being a scenery controls setup for folks who are trying to control the scenery generation, and the pane on the right showing us what the final output is going to look like when users are interacting with it on their screen. And that concludes a brief demo of the application. Of course, we can switch over to the code base and further modify the different prompts, for example, of our nano lava model, say, share the stylistic aspects of the image only instead of an image description, and also share additional information, such as information about our screen resolution for the different settings, for our individual models, as well as for our Llama 3 8 billion instruct model, additional details on the prompt side and things that we would like to see. As part of this application, we've also implemented a safety checker for our latent consistency model's image generator in order to ensure that all of the content that's generated is safe. Of course, there can be additional hallucinations and sometimes different types of images that can be generated with these kinds of models. So it's important to also explore some of the advanced parameters here. For example, playing around with the guidance, steps, and seed parameters for the latent consistency models, along with the prompts that are being used here. Let's briefly take a look at how this is being able to be done real time. As I mentioned earlier, we've taken each of these models and converted it to the OpenVINO format in order to get optimized performance on different types of compute engines. Now, given that I'm running this particular demo on an AI PC, an Intel Core Ultra 9 to be exact, we're able to run this real time efficiently and smoothly by making sure that different models are being run on different compute engines. Here, I have my Depth Anything and Super Resolution models running on the CPU, my Whisper and Latent Consistency models being split across the NPU and the GPU, and my Llama 3 and Nano Lava models running on the GPU. We can see an example of how this is being done for latent consistency models if we go ahead and search in the file here and look for the different device usage as well. You're also welcome to edit this as you see fit and change the device values, for example, the CPU and GPU if you have a non-AI PC setup or don't have an NPU available for your setup. In general, a good rule of thumb is to offload different tasks that could use an AI boost to the NPU for that optimized performance using the OpenVINO toolkit, and keep your intensive workloads on the GPU and your less intensive workloads on the CPU. By using the three compute engines effectively, we're able to balance our compute and also make sure that you can offload additional tasks, like maybe some extra fancy display-related items that you'd like to add on to this, to the GPU for additional processing while keeping your AI model compute utilization relatively low. Again, the radio.ui.python file shares a lot of different opportunities for how to edit it and incorporate different types of device values depending on the devices that you support and have supported on your system. This reference kit can also be applied to countless other applications, including retail and e-commerce, education and training, and so many other applications, such as architecture and interior design, for being able to generate engaging scenery that can be adjusted real time and could be used in a collaborative environment as well. Additionally, we have a lot of other resources to explore to be able to bridge this further. For example, AI PC resources and OpenVINO toolkit resources as well, to better explore the compute on the hardware side and on the software side, the different AI models and technologies that are used as part of this demo and can be used to extend it further, including large language models, image generation models, AI computer vision based models, and so much more. We'd also welcome you to check out our other Edge AI reference kits in the OpenVINO Build Deploy repository to find more templated solutions to make it easy to develop AI technologies at scale for production settings.